It's a miracle. He's got his boots. We didn't have to look one bit.
Go ahead, get in.
I've been working hard to get three of these pigs out on a forested system, two of them on a deep bedding system, the demo for my upcoming project, Permaculture Pigs, launching on Kickstarter May 20th.
Kevin?
Can't work on preparing the forest today because yesterday something went wrong with my chainsaw. Notice the chain adjuster is broken in there, but I got it into my mechanic, so hopefully that'll be fixed soon. I was hoping to do the Korean natural method, which is essentially a deep bedding system that is pretty much, once you set it up, self-maintained. It was gonna be really cool. I'm actually a little bit ahead of time today. Actually gonna milk a little bit earlier because we're gonna go to town. I got Mr. Brown warming up on a audiobook. What, you don't like Zig Ziglar?
No. Then slowly he stood up.
Now just pick one you do want. While he's doing that, I'm gonna work on the Kickstarter description, just describing what it is, describing the documentary, describing the course. I need to get that to my assistant, Heather, by Thursday. Today's Tuesday, to have this ready by Monday. I would really like to get it to her today or tomorrow. Well, that was a good 5-6 minutes. That's kind of how it's been. A lot of farming, a little bit of office work, especially in the spring. Mr. Brown enjoying Curious George. Thank you for the reminder, bro.
You look bundled up. I've got two coats on. We're all like 40 degrees. Ah!
I was on it, man. I was on it. I was gonna milk an hour early. I'm afraid this is gonna cut into it. Unless, by some miracle, we can get this done in 12 minutes. You guys are looking good. Donald, you're owning these chicks, buddy. Took him a few days, but he's totally adopted them. They're at the end of this. This is gonna come back like 10 times richer. We're building the soil in one of the weaker parts of our farm, weaker pastures. We sort of need to go like right here. That's not a full two nets. It might be. I kind of just want to stay in a line. So we go down there and then we'll turn around and go this way. It's best to move your chickens right next to where they've been. They will follow a bucket.
Grab a bucket so they'll go around. Can you guys go get those other ones?
And yeah, Donald? Here.
There you guys go. There you go. Oh, almost, almost, almost. Almost. You just won't go in there. Come on, you're there. There you go. All right, how'd we do on time, Jonah? We got them in, that's looking good. It's 8:40. No way it's 8:40. Hopefully it's 8:14. Incidentally, those guys are getting some replacements. They might arrive tomorrow. Certainly the next day, 100 more chickens. Okay, Gideon, you gonna come with me? You wanna come with me to milk? Let's put the scrap bucket back. And let's grab the milk buckets and the tumbler. Do you see the tumbler? There it is. Will you grab it for me, Gideon? So, my friend Randy Kleiman and I have been researching the Korean natural method. It's an amazing system, and we can get all the stuff to make it happen. Logs, grass clippings, charcoal, shed. But you gotta inoculate the pile. And that takes a recipe that involves wheat mids. For the life of me, I cannot source wheat mids unless I want to buy 2,000 pounds of wheat mids. Thanks to Randy for helping me with that research. Guys, if you wanna check out Randy's channel, Homesteader in Minnesota, even in the minus 60, his channel, I'll leave the link down in the description. And hopefully I'll remember to put it up there as a card. You can click on it and go watch his channel there.
Thank you, Josiah.
Hi, the cast room. You guys are doing good. So I don't want to give up on the deep bedding system either, because that's a perfect solution, I think. Well, maybe nothing's perfect, but it's a great solution for somebody in a small space. So not only am I trying to be sensitive of small spaces, but also, you know, time sensitivities. So I'm thinking Joel Salatin deep bedding compost system. He would have had the cows in this area during the winter on deep mulch, probably wood chips. Easy to give them some hay, taking a break during the winter. While he's building up the mulch underneath the cows, balancing out the manure, he puts corn in there. See, I first found out about Joel Salatin's system a long time ago in one of his books, where he'll have cows on deep bedding all winter in a barn, and then he brings the pigs in to stir in that manure and that wood chips, and they just love it.
Look, you can see him finding something in there.
No, no. No, no, I'm not the corn. I'm not the corn, buddy. So, why not a composter pig system like that?
All right, Jonah, let's switch her out.
Did you set up their next pasture?
Yeah, all I had to do was her stand up and out and open up a gate, because at the end of the lane, it's open.
Good. So I've already got this carport coming. Why not build this compost system in place on a garden? Let's go to town and get some supplies. Let's pick up some stuff for the forest pig. We need to get water line out there. Anyway, let's see what Lowe's has to offer us by way of that. Town day. The good thing about living on the farm, working at home, is we don't go to town much. The bad thing about it is when we go to town, we go to town.
Do a lot of stuff.
Can't just go to one place. Lowe's and Tractor Supply.
It wasn't that hard. Nose,
we're doing good.
I know. I'm like, we're going to get home soon.
Let's do it. Four cattle panels. So do you want to do the tomato stuff?
Yeah, I'll get the tomatoes.
And I'll go look at everything else.
Yep.
Barn chain oil. Look, could we get a new bar here?
It's this one.
I wrote it down. No, it's a 16. I took a picture of it. There's a 20-inch. Chainsaw is so old, it isn't even listed on here. Hey, Rebecca. I'm at the chainsaws.
Okay, I'll be right there.
Let's try it. It won't hurt to try it, right? We'll just bring it back if it doesn't work. Here we are in the plumbing. We need drinking safe water line. Hopefully we're not gonna have to buy hose. Is this it?
Ours is black.
This looks like it. This is too easy so far. 300 lines, 300 feet, they have two more. That's exactly what we need. Connectors though, connectors. Dude, you totally found connectors. Well, that was surprisingly painless compared to some of my previous projects. This is gonna look... Rebecca, you've gone Ben crazy.
I'm just organizing, because I'm an organized person.
Okay, well, remember what Ben Franklin said? Was it Ben Franklin?
What did he say?
For every minute organizing, you're going to save an hour off your life.
Well, I hope that.
I hope it's true. All right, we've got our materials. The gentleman's getting our PEX down. We're going with PEX line. This was a lot less painful than the Everflow waterer. It's only like 1 o'clock. I thought this was going to take till 5 o'clock.
I
can actually edit
it's
before.
It's funny, I had thought... I was like, this is not going to take as long at all.
Oh, you didn't see my list.